العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيب نفوسنا وشفيع ذنوبنا أبي القاسم محمد اللهم صل على محمد صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا اللهم صل على محمد ومحمد. Respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله, we thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى for the blessing of the month of Ramadan, which made us to meet again, alhamdulillah, here in Salt Lake City after last Ramadan. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will accept our fastings, insha'Allah. Wa alaikum salam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our du'as, our a'mal, and all the ibadah which we have been doing in this month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, once again, I take this opportunity to extend all the tabrikat, barakah of the month of Ramadan, knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown His mercy to each and every one of us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us be able to finish the fasting of the holy month of Ramadan. And we pray sincerely that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will include many of us, insha'Allah, to go for Hajj this year and the years to come, insha'Allah. Tonight's topic, I want to divide it into two sections. Section number one, I want to talk about taqwa and the month of Ramadan, and asking ourselves a question: have we changed ourselves or not? Because the month of Ramadan is the month of change. This hadith of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Which talks about three things, which inshallah I'm going to mention them. And why the question which will end with the first section. Why sometimes when we do du'as, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He doesn't reply to our du'as. While He says in the Holy Quran, Ayah 187 of Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. If my servants ask you, O Prophet, about me, I'm so near, I'm so closer. In terms of proximity, I'm so near to them. And I answer the supplication of the suppliant whenever he supplicates to me. The question is why sometimes we ask Allah and du'as are not accepted. So inshallah we'll finish first section one with that. In section two, I would like to talk about people who are known as Ahlul Haqq, the people of Haqq, the people who follow rights, and I will explain more about that insha'Allah. To begin tonight's topic about Shahr Ramadan and Taqwa, we need to ask ourselves this question based on the ayah. Allah says in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 183, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, kutiba alaykumus siyam, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqoon. O you who believe, fasting is prescribed for you. Fasting is made wajib upon you, the way it was made wajib upon those who were before you, la'allakum tattaqoon, so that you may have taqwa. Taqwa is the end result of us fasting in the month of Ramadan. If we are gaining a lot of benefits in the month of Ramadan while we are fasting, yes, we become thinner. Yes, we become slimmer. Yes, we become people who can control many things. But however, all those reasons are not important more than having taqwa. Because taqwa is the end result of fasting. If we fast and then our taqwa remains in the same level before the month of Ramadan and after the month of Ramadan, it means you and me, we have not achieved much. Because Allah says the reason of fasting is la'allakum tattaqoon, so that you may have taqwa. We ask ourselves, what is taqwa? According to the hadith of Imam Amirul Mu'mineen Ali bin Abi Talib alayhi salam, Allahumma salli wa sallam. Imam describes taqwa in four things. He says taqwa, the characteristics of taqwa are four things. Number one, taqwa will make us fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, taqwa will make us act according to the revelation of the Holy Quran. Number three, taqwa will make us to be sufficient or to accept that little which we have, that which Allah has given us as rizq. And number four, taqwa will make us be ready, prepare ourselves for the day when we will be departed from this world, ready to fast another life, which is the life of Akhirah. So if this is taqwa, fasting of the month of Ramadan will help us to achieve these four things and even more. When Imam Amirul Mu'mineen was approached by Hammam, Al-Hammam, his companion, and he said, swiftly Al-Muttaqeen, O Amirul Mu'mineen, I want you to give me the characteristics of Muttaqeen. Imam Amirul Mu'mineen looked at his companion Hammam and he said, you will not be able to bear the characteristics of Muttaqeen because those are special people. Hammam said, swiftly Ya Amir Al-Mu'mineen, Ka'anni Arahum, talk to me about Al-Muttaqeen as if I see them in front of me. Imam started explaining about Al-Muttaqeen. And I ask you, brothers and sisters, when you have time, take Nahjul Balagha, look at the index, look at the Fahris, you will see the Khutbatul Muttaqeen, the name Khutbatul Muttaqeen in Nahjul Balagha. Imam Amirul Mu'minin started talking about Al-Muttaqeen. Today I'm not talking about that. Inshallah, a time will come. When he finished talking, describing the characteristics of Muttaqeen, Hammam passed away. Hammam died. He couldn't bear. He wanted to be among the Muttaqeen, and indeed, he was among Al-Muttaqeen. But then he died. Why? Because of knowing the characteristics of Al-Muttaqeen. So when we talk about Al-Muttaqeen, you cannot talk about Al-Muttaqeen without talking about taqwa. And taqwa, as we have said, is the end result of fasting. So Allah says again, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, kutiba alaykumu siyam, kama kutiba ala ladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqoon. So the end result, if it's taqwa, we need to elevate ourselves to go to the level of taqwa, in order for us to be muttaqeen, the people who Hammam wanted to know them. Ikhwani wa akhawati, nahnu fi shahri Ramadan. Wa naqra hadhihi al-aya fi surati al-Baqara, aya 183. Wa hiya ya ayuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyamu kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Idha sa'alna anfusana ma fa'idatu as-sawm? هل الصوم معناه الامتناع عن الأكل والشرب فقط أو هناك فوائد كثيرة لأننا إذا امتنعنا عن الأكل والشرب سوف نكون يعني سوف نكون ضعفاء من ناحية الجسم سوف نخفف أوزاننا بلا إشكال وكما يقول الرسول صوم تصح سوف نجد الصحة في الصيام ولكن الهدف الأخير للصيام التقوى لماذا؟ لأن الله يقول لعلكم تتقون وحينما ننظر إلى هذه الكلمة الكبيرة التقوى نجد حديث عن الإمام أمير المؤمنين سلام الله عليه حيث يقول التقوى عبارة عن أربعة خوف من الجليل أولا والعمل بالتنزيل ثانيا والرضا بالقليل ثالثة والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. حينما تنظر إلى هذا الحديث تجد كل المواصفات للتقوى. خوف من الجليل، الخوف هذا يعني ليس خوف عادي، معناه أننا نعرف إذا عصينا الله أنه يرانا. إذا أردنا أن نقوم بأي شيء هو حرام الله أمامنا، وسوف لا نقوم إلا بما يرضي الله سبحانه وتعالى، حتى وصفه الله وصفه الرسول في حديثه معنى الإحسان، يقول الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه وإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراه. فإذا صفات أو مواصفات للتقوى أولا هو الخوف من الجليل، أما الثاني والعمل بالتنزيل، نقوم بما كل ما أنزله الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه المجيد وبما جاء به الرسول صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. اللهم صل على محمد. العمل بالتنزيل والرضا بالقليل، كل ما عندك أنت في يدك هذا يكفيك أنت وعائلتك، لا تتمنى الذي عند أيدي الآخرين حتى تقول لماذا الله أعطاني هذا القليل. لأن إذا أنت حاسبت نفسك أنك عندك قليل، هناك من ليس عندهم الذي عندك أنت بيدك. الرضا بالقليل. وأما الثالث الرضا بعد الرضا بالقليل الثالث والأخير والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. استعداد ليوم الرحيل، نحن في الرحلة، نحن دائما حينما يأتي يوم جديد وآجالنا قريب، غدا سنموت، لا ندري هل غدا غدا بمعنى غد أو غدا هو القريب الذي يأتي، كلما هو آتي فهو قريب. فنحن علينا أن نستعد لهذا اليوم الذي سوف نرحل، ليس أننا نريد أن نرتحل، بل الملائكة سوف يأتوننا ويخرجوننا من هذا المكان. تمر الأيام والليالي من شهر رمضان ونحن نسأل أنفسنا ماذا زرعنا في أنفسنا بالنسبة للتقوى. حينما نقسم الأشياء إلى قسمين، إلى الإيجابيات والسلبيات، ونحن اليوم في اليوم 11 من شهر رمضان، هل بدأنا صيام شهر رمضان ودخل شهر رمضان ونحن على ما كنا عليه قبل شهر رمضان أو غيرنا أنفسنا؟ My dear brothers and sisters, when we look at the days and month of the days and nights of the month of Ramadan, we need to ask ourselves a very important question. What have we achieved in this holy month? Because if we were waiting for the holy month to come, the holy month of Ramadan is already here. No, not already here. It's about to end because we have finished 10 days of the month of Ramadan. And now what is coming is easy. We are not climbing, but we are going down in terms of the days and nights. If you and me have not performed Salatul Layl, what are we waiting for? If you and me, we have not started recitation of the Holy Quran, what are we waiting for? If you and me, we haven't changed that bad akhlaq to become a good akhlaq, what are we waiting for? Because the first 10 is gone. We don't have another month of Ramadan. We have maybe 19 days only, or 20 days of the month of Ramadan. So we need to change here. As we understand, the month of Ramadan is that month of purification of the soul, where we purified ourselves to become better people. We purify our souls in order for us to become better parents. We purify our souls in order for us to become better children. The month of Ramadan is the month of purification. The Holy Prophet, before I mention the hadith, we need to look at ourselves when we come closer to other people. How do we treat others? Others in terms of Muslims or non-Muslims. Do we think that we are better than them, or are we superior or inferior? listen to the hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Allahumma sallam. The Holy Prophet says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَمَ ثَلَاثَةً فِي ثَلَاثَةٍ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَمَ ثَلَاثَةً فِي ثَلَاثَةٍ كَتَمَ رِضَاهُ فِي طَاعَتِهِ وَكَتَمَ سَخَطَهُ فِي مَعْصِيَتِهِ وَكَتَمَ وَلِيَّهُ فِي خَلْقِهِ فَلَا يَسْتَخِفَّنَّ أَحَدُكُمْ شَيْئًا مِنَ الطَّاعَةِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَدْرِي فِي أَيِّ رِضَا فِي أَيِّهَا رِضَى اللَّهِ فَلَا فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَدْرِي فِي أَيِّهَا رِضَى اللَّهِ وَلَا يَسْتَخِفَّنَّ أَحَدُكُمْ شَيْئًا مِنَ الْمَعَاصِي فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَدْرِي فِي أَيِّهَا سخط الله ولا يزرين أحدكم بأحد من خلق الله فإنه لا يدري أيهم ولي الله. هذا حديث حديث جليل. والله this hadith is so special. When you look at it, you understand the meaning of it. You look at yourself, the way you act when you are with others, it tells us a lot. That the Holy Prophet says, indeed, Allah put three things in other three things. And He hid three things in the other three things. He says, number one, Allah made a hidden His rida, His happiness in His ta'ah. It means that when you obey Allah in His obedience, there is happiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you want to make Allah happy, you need to obey Him. Number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hid His anger in His ma'asiyah. Meaning what? The anger of Allah is covered. However, if we commit ma'asiyah, then Allah will make His wrath, His anger to come to us. And number three, He hid His wali, that servant of Allah who worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, among His creature. So you cannot know wali of Allah in His creature after Rasulullah, after awliya, meaning a'imma alayhimus salam, and all other people. We still have people who are awliyaullah, but you will not be able to know them because Allah has hidden them among His creature. Now the Holy Prophet says, do not belittle anything in terms of obedience. To say that this is little, I will not do it because it's so little. He says, because you don't know, in that little, there is happiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't lose the opportunity. And He says, do not belittle anything which is ma'asiyah of Allah by saying, this is little ma'asiyah, I can do it, no problem at all, because this is a small thing. He says, no, don't do that, because by committing that little ma'asiyah, maybe the anger of Allah is within that small ma'asiyah, and Allah may punish you because of that. And then He says, do not belittle anybody among Muslims, because the one you belittle, he could be the wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now when you look at this hadith, it tells us that our behavior towards others, the way we look at others, the way we talk to others, we need to be very careful about that. And it is here, as it has been saying, that the world is full of surprises. Something can make you to be surprised, because either you take it as a little thing, while that is so big. Ad-dunya mamlu'atun bil-ajaib wal-gharaib kama yuqal. Shahr Ramadan huwa shahr ad-du'a. Nahnu nad'u Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi du'a al-iftitah الأدعية بعد الفرائض يا علي يا عظيم اللهم أدخل على أهل القبور السرور دعاء أبي حمزة الثمالي دعاء سحر كل هذه الأدعية جيدة وجميلة جدا ولكن في بعض الأوقات نسأل أنفسنا لماذا الله لا يجيبنا حينما نسأله ما المشكلة أنا أدعوه وهو يقول أدعوني أستجب لكم ما السر في عدم استجابة الدعاء السر موجودة أو السر موجود في حديث الإمام الباقر عليه السلام حيث يقول إن العبد يسأل الله الحاجة فيكون من شأنه قضاؤها إلى أجل قريب أو إلى وقت بطيء فيذنب العبد ذنبا الإمام يقول فيذنب العبد ذنبا فيقول الله تبارك وتعالى للملك لا تقضي حاجته واحرمه فإنه تعرض لسخطي واستوجب الحرمان مني هذا هو الجواب نحن ندعو ونعصي الله نحن ندعو عندنا حاجة وفي نفس الوقت نرتكب المعاصي الله يقول أدعوني أستجب لكم وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب ولكن حينما نرتكب المعصية الله يقول للملك لا 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 دعاؤه الآن غير مستجاب فإذا دواؤنا منا وداؤنا منا كذلك كما يقول أمير المؤمنين سلام الله عليه فما أننا في شهر رمضان علينا أن نتذكر قضية حينما ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى بالجد والاجتهاد فعلينا أن لا نعصي الله سبحانه وتعالى حتى يجيب أدعيتنا أو دعاءنا حينما ندعوه Why, brothers and sisters, sometimes when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray to Allah. The month of Ramadan is the month of dua. All those duas, dua sahar, dua iftitah, dua Abu Hamza Thumali, dua after salah, ya aliyu ya azim, Allahumma adkhil ala ahli al-kubur al-surur. All these duas are so beautiful. But the question here is why sometimes when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He doesn't reply to our duas. Why? Maybe there is hikmah, there is wisdom. Without any doubt, you look at the messengers of Allah. Zakaria, the prophet of Allah, he had his son Yahya. Yahya, there is a very beautiful comparison between Yahya and Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Yahya was born after 6 months of pregnancy. Same thing with Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Yahya gave all his life for the sake of Allah. Similarly, Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Yahya was slaughtered, his head was chopped off. Why? Because people wanted to make him a loser in front of the king of his time. Similarly, what happened to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Yahya wasn't born until his father, Zakaria, was 90 plus of age and his mother was about 80 plus of age. Zakaria, the messenger of Allah, is asking Allah, Ya Allah, I ask you a son, Yarithuni wa Yarithu min Ali Yaqub, so that he can inherit me and inherit the family of Yaqub. Allah says, no problem, you will get the son. He says, give me sign. I want to know the signs that my wife will be pregnant of a son or whoever you're giving me. He says, Ayatuka Allah tukallima an-nasa thalatha layalin illa ramza. You will not be able to speak to people for 3 consecutive days except you will use sign languages only. And then yes, Zakaria used to call people for salah in the morning. Salah, salah, the way some people do. On that particular morning, he comes out, he calls people for salah, nothing comes out of his mouth. He wants to say salah, he can't say. He remembers, oh, this is the sign of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, so my wife will become pregnant. And indeed, few days, wife become pregnant. After 6 months, Zakaria sees the boy by the name Yahya. Allah says, Ya Yahya, khudhil kitaba bi quwwa. O Yahya, keep upright. Do what Allah wants you to do. Yahya becomes a servant of Allah, messenger. Eventually people kill him. Dua of Zakaria was replied after 5 years. Messenger of Allah. 5 years, Allah says, now I have given your reply to the dua. You will get a son. If the messenger of Allah took him 5 years for the dua to be replied, what about you and me? It can take long time. However, sometimes it's not the maslaha that stops the dua. It's because of ma'asiyah we commit. Listen to the hadith of Imam, the fifth Imam, Abi Ja'far, Imam Al-Bakir alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad. He says, indeed, a servant may ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a particular need. فَيَكُونُ مِنْ شَأْنِهِ قَضَاءُهَا. Allah wants to reply to this dua. إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ. After few days, few months, few years. فَيُذْنِبُ الْعَبْدُ ذَنْبًا. But then this person who asked Allah for dua, he commits a sin. Once that happened, Allah talks to the angels and he tells, oh my angels, don't give that haja, that need this particular person was asking. And Allah stops the dua. And this is because why? He has committed ma'asiyah. Allah says, فَإِنَّهُ تَعَرَّضَ لِسَخَطِي وَاسْتَوْجَبَ الْحِرْمَانُ مِنِّي. It's because he has made me angry, and that's why I will not reply to his dua. Brothers and sisters, the month of Ramadan is here. Insha'Allah ta'ala, we will be together until the end of the month of Ramadan. And in this series of lectures, I want to establish one thing. And insha'Allah, that will be beneficial to me, number one. And I hope it will be beneficial to you too, insha'Allah. Silsilatul Muhadarat hawla shi'ati Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. We want to talk about the biography of the followers of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Those who are known as Shias. You and me, we are known as Shias. We call ourselves Shias. But are we truly Shias? Maybe yes. And insha'Allah, we hope that we'll be Shias of Ali. But however, we want to look and examine the biography of many of the followers of Ali ibn Abi Talib until the end of the month of Ramadan, in order for us to look at them and compare them with us, compare them to us, in order for us to say, are we really followers of Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam? So I think it will be interesting for us to come and to know these followers of Haq, who are known as Ahlul Haq, those who are with Imam Amirul Mu'mineen alayhi salam. Why? The topic is because we have 3 nights of Ali ibn Abi Talib in the month of Ramadan. Ali ibn Abi Talib attained his Shahada on the night of 21st of Ramadan. And there were a few Shias around him. So we want to know those who are with him, those Shia who stood with Amirul Mu'mineen, those Shias who lost their lives in the lifetime of Amirul Mu'mineen, what kind of people were there? So inshallah, this one will be my topic, biography of the followers of Ali ibn Abi Talib, biography of the Shia of Ali ibn Abi Talib, in order for us to learn something out of their lives, inshallah. فَإِذَا inshallah سَتَكُونُ مُحَاضَرَاتِ حَوْلَ حَيَاتِ شِيَةَ عَلِي كَيْفَ عَاشُ فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا هِيَ الْمَشَاكِلِ الَّتِي عَانُوهَا وَكَيْفَ اسْتَطَاعُوا أن يبقوا مع علي بن أبي طالب عليه السلام لأننا سوف نتكلم حول علي بن أبي طالب في 3 ليالي. كلما نتكلم عن علي عليه السلام ماذا نعرف عن أصحابه؟ فإذا إن شاء الله محاضراتي ستكون سلسلة حياة لهؤلاء الشيعة حتى نقارن أنفسنا وأنفسهم، نقول هل نحن شيعة حقيقة أو لا؟ إن شاء الله بإذن الله نحن شيعة علي في الدنيا والآخرة إن شاء الله. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى، we ask Allah to accept our أعمال إن شاء الله. And we ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to accept our fastings and duas إن شاء الله. We ask Allah to cure all the marid, those who are not feeling well. Ya Allah, cure them بشفاعة محمد وآل محمد. Ya Allah, our marhumin, we ask you to have mercy on their graves. Ya Allah, make those graves to be among the gardens of paradise. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Rahim Allah man qara al-Fatiha qablaha as-salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.